Hi, Mariners kids. Welcome to the Big Picture Show. I'm Brittany.
And I'm Sam. We are so excited you're here for another amazing adventure.
Kids, we have an exciting series planned. Sam, do you play video games?
Are you kidding? I'm a total gamer. And I bet a lot of you are too.
Well, I mean, I'm not really a gamer girl.
What? Are you kidding? Brittany, during this series, I will teach you how to be a total gamer. Pinky promise.
Okay. Oh, Sam, that reminds me of our big picture question. Does God keep his promises?
That's a great question. And I know the answer. He does. He is faithful even when we are not.
Kids, you're going to be learning all about God's faithfulness during this series. So let's stand up and worship together.
Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. There's a city that calls me by name. There's a city that calls me by name. Yes, as I run this race, I am cheered by the saints. There's a city that calls me by name. There's a future that runs through my veins. There's a future that runs through my veins. And there's nothing on earth that can stand in the way. There's a future.
The same spirit I cannot contain.
Where I go with you. Every
Man, what is up with this Wi-Fi? I'm almost at the next level. Oh, come on, come on! Gosh! Mom! Dad! Please, can you stop working? I need help with this Wi-Fi! Oh, man, come on! Whoa, what are you doing? You made me lose a life!
Dude, you're gonna have to get off the Xbox soon. When Sophia gets home, we're gonna be wanting to play some Zelda.
Oh, Zelda, I love Zelda. Especially level 7. Did I tell you that last time I actually got the red candle? And, you know I'm Sophia's favorite brother, right?
For sure.
She told me herself. I'm the baby, gotta love me.
Look, I may be the middle child, but at least I got the looks.
Okay, whatever. Oh, wait, Oliver, before you leave, can you please help me with the Wi-Fi? Please, come back. Come on, I'll just do it myself.
I'm serious, Josh. Get off the Xbox.
Oliver? Where's my favorite brother? Josh, where are you, bro?
I don't know, but the Xbox is free. Wanna play some Zelda?
Oh, yes! This is my favorite part about being home from college. This game is such a relic. I'll own you.
Oh, we'll see about that.
Game on, bro.
Those be fighting words.
Oops, sorry. Dude, this game is seriously lagging, bro.
Yeah, I know, it's kinda weird, but let's just keep playing.
Hey, watch the friendly fire!
This gun is...
Okay, dude, I'm like seriously lagging here. What is going on? Oliver, this game is lagging a lot. I thought Mom and Dad upgraded the Wi-Fi during quarantine.
I know, but they said it was too expensive, so we're stuck with the old cheap Wi-Fi. Here, let me check the router. Maybe it needs a reboot or something.
Whoa! What did you just do? I've never seen it do that before.
I just messed with this wire.
It just did it again.
Oh, well, that's kind of cool. I mean, I don't know what I did. But
well, sit. Clearly you didn't fix it. Move over, let a girl do it.
Whatever.
Whoa! What just happened?
I'm not sure. I play a lot of video games, and I've never seen that happen before.
Okay, we'll check on them in a minute. But first, let's check out our first edition of Whip It Up.
It sounds like a cooking competition.
It is a cooking competition. I don't know anything about video games, really, but I know a lot about food, and it is going to be exciting. Let's watch it together.
Welcome to Whip It Up. I'm your host, Unique Monique, and today parents and kids are going to compete against another parent and kid for our cooking challenge. They're going to compete to win the golden spatula, but in order to win the golden spatula, they're going to have to impress my co-host, the world-renowned kid chef, Luca Dossi.
Welcome, everyone. I hope these teams are up for the challenge. Let's meet our teams, then.
I'm Jessica.
And I'm Sayla.
And we are the Cooking Queens. I'm Nicole.
I'm Samantha.
And we are the Donut Duo.
Awesome. Our first challenge today is Breakfast Towers. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
You guys are going to compete to make the largest tower that you can by using all the ingredients on the table and only the ingredients on the table. On your mark, get set, go. Luca, I have to ask, who do you think's doing the best right now?
Let me just tell me how the donut duos are doing.
I mean, I looked at both of them, they're doing awesome. They're doing pretty good. I love what they're using over here to create the strength of their tower, but over here they're creating a firm foundation. I'd say they're doing pretty good.
Here they're focusing on height.
They're focusing on the height. Awesome job.
Exactly what I'd expect from the queen. Time's up.
Time is up. Let's check out our towers. I think that tells who wins our competition. from the height of our towers. Luca, which tower is the tallest here? I brought you a measuring tape so that you can check it out. We're gonna have to give our golden spatula to our team on this side. Congratulations. We will see you guys next week on our next episode of Whip It Up.
Oh, I'm so hungry now.
That was so fun and funny. Those parents were not messing around.
They weren't. Now, let's check in with Jordan to hear a true story from the Bible.
Whoa, like where are Sophia and Oliver? Like, where did they go? What happened to them? Are they okay? Oh, are we rolling already? I didn't see that you were on. All right, let's get to our story. Hey, Mariners kids, if you're new to the show, my name is Jordan, and I'm so glad that you're with us today. We've been on this journey with God's people, the Israelites. Now, they were in captivity, and some had returned to Jerusalem. However, not all of them went back. And today, we will hear about a woman who stayed in Persia. Now, her name was Esther, and God planned to use her for a very important job. And the first part of God's plan for her was to make her the queen of Persia. And so as we listen to our story, Esther became queen. Think about this question. Does God keep his promises? Try to figure out the answer from the story. And this will be our big picture question for the entire unit. So don't forget it. We will have 5 more sessions after today that will answer the same question. So let's check out our video.
When Cyrus was king of Persia, he sent some of God's people back to Judah to rebuild the temple in Jerusalem. God's people were called Jews because they were from Judah. Though some Jews returned to Judah to rebuild the temple, many Jews were still in Persia when Ahasuerus became the new king of Persia. When the king's wife did not listen to him, he decided to not let her be queen anymore. The king of Persia needed a queen. He chose Esther to be queen. Esther was very beautiful. She was a Jew and had been raised by her cousin, Mordecai. Esther did not tell the king that she was a Jew. One day, Mordecai heard that Haman, a very important leader who worked for the king, was planning to kill all the Jews. Mordecai was upset. He was a Jew. He did not want all the people he loved to be killed. Mordecai and all the Jews cried. Esther did not know what was wrong. She sent a messenger to ask Mordecai why all the Jews were upset. Mordecai told Esther about Haman's evil plan. "You have to do something," Mordecai said. "You are the queen. Ask the king to stop Haman. Ask him to save the Jewish people." Esther sent a message back to Mordecai. "No one can approach the king unless the king calls for that person first," Esther said. "The punishment is death. Unless the king holds out his scepter, then you may live." Mordecai encouraged Esther to think about it. "You are a Jew," he said. "If you do not stop Haman, he will kill you too. Maybe this is why you are the queen. Maybe God put Esther in the palace to save her people." Esther asked Mordecai to gather the Jewish people and fast. They would not eat or drink for 3 days. They would pray to God for help. Then Esther would go to the king. She was willing to die to save the Jews. God's plan all along was to send the Messiah through Abraham's family. Haman's evil plan might have stopped God's plan, but God was in control. He was working out a plan to use Esther to rescue his people and make the way for his son, Jesus, to come into the world.
Wow, what a story. Now God's people were in a really scary situation there. That guy Haman did not like Mordecai or any of the Jewish people. And then the king of Persia, he needed to choose a new queen, and he chose Esther. Now the king did not know that Esther was a Jew. Even in the king's choice, God was in control. Now God knew that Haman wanted to kill all of the Jewish people, but he was controlling the situation to protect his people. Even Esther's cousin Mordecai thought that God was going to use Esther to help save God's people. And Mordecai told Esther, "Who knows? Perhaps you have come to your royal position for such a time as this." You see, Esther's choice to help God's people, it was not an easy choice. The king, he had this rule that no one could go to him unless he called for that person. And so if Esther went to the king without an invitation, he could have killed her. But if the king held out his scepter, that meant he would allow her to live. And so Esther agreed to help her people, even if it meant that she might die. That's incredible, right? Now, do you remember the big picture question that I asked? Say it with me. Does God keep his promises? And the answer is yes. God is always faithful, even when we are not. And so God's plan all along was to send the Messiah, the Savior, through Abraham's family. And Haman's evil plan might have stopped God's plan, but God was in control the whole time. He was working out a plan to use Esther to rescue his people and make the way for his son, Jesus, to come into the world. And so even when life is scary and we are unsure about the future, we can still trust that our life is in God's hands. Just as God worked to protect his people from Haman's plot, he sent Jesus to protect us from sin by dying on the cross and rising again on the third day. That's our story for today, so let's pray together. Jesus, thank you so much for being in control. Thank you for coming down here and for dying on the cross for our sins and for always being faithful to your promises and being faithful to those who love you. We pray all this in your name. Amen. Thank you for joining me for our Bible story about Esther today. Now let's jump back into Game Central to see what happened to Oliver and Sophia.
What just happened?
Where are we?
I want my mommy.
I think I do too. Do you think we can call her?
Maybe. Here, let me get my... Where's my phone? I think I left it on the... Where's the couch?
Oh, I don't know. It's so weird looking in here.
Wait. Oh no, I think we're in the Xbox. It's Game Central.
Wait, what? We're inside the Xbox? Wait, how did we get here? Wait, how are we gonna get out? Wait, we're in the Xbox, how?
I don't know, maybe we can press the reset?
Oliver, Sophia, is that you? It's me, Josh, help me, I'm over here.
Josh, what are you doing? Where's your body? Can you please just get down here so we can get out of here? But find your body first.
I can't, I'm stuck.
What do you mean you're stuck?
1 minute I'm messing with the cables and next minute I'm in the Xbox.
What game are you in? I can't see behind that big head of yours.
I'm in Super Smash Brothers and it is really scary in here. You know Drowser? He is real and he is even weirder looking and even scarier in person.
Drowser?
Yeah.
Real?
He says if we want to get out, one of you has to battle him.
Sophia, you gotta do it. You're the best at Duper Mash Bros.
Let me think. Josh, how did you get in there?
Well, I was where you were, you know, in Game Central. And then I started looking around, touching some stuff, and then I heard a voice.
A voice?
He said his name was King X.
King X?
Yeah, King X. He said, if we want to get out of here, we have to beat every game. Well, technically he said, "You clearly don't belong here, young man. I see you shaking in your skin. If you want to make it out of here, all of the games you must win."
Wait, this is perfect. You're insane at Duper Mash Bros. We'll be in and out of here before no time. And I can be munching down on little Napoleon pizza back at home.
No, you're crazy, okay? It's one thing to play the game, but it's another to go inside there and face a real-life drowser.
Sophia, you're the best at Duper Mash Bros. You got this.
I can't, okay? I just can't. There's too much at stake. This is real, okay? What if I lose?
What do you mean? This isn't like you at all.
Because, Oliver, I'm scared, okay? When I lose to Drowser at home, I just hit reset and start over. But this is real. What if I lose and get stuck here forever?
I mean, I guess you're right, but I just didn't think you of all people would be afraid.
Of course I'm afraid. 10 minutes ago, we were sitting on the couch, and now Josh is a floating head. Still really freaks me out.
Look, Sophia, I'm scared too, but I'm going to support you. I'm here with you the whole time. I'll be cheering you on. I believe in you.
Okay, what if it doesn't work?
Sophia, we have to trust King X. I know he's going to keep his promise. You just have to win.
Okay, let's do it.
My God is strong. He'll do anything big or small. Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God. Every day I can know God is always there for me and my family. Every day I can know greater is the one who lives inside.
I can't believe those kids got stuck inside their Xbox. It actually sounds pretty fun.
No, that kind of sounds scary to me, but since they have a plan to rescue Josh and get home, I think it's okay. Do you hear that? Sophia, is that you?
Yeah. Hey, guys. It's me.
Hi, Sophia. You are so rad and so brave. You're going to do great.
Thanks so much. But to be honest, I'm really, really nervous. I just hope I can beat Drowser and get out of here.
Sophia, you're going to kill it.
Yeah, and King X promised he would let you out if you do.
And that reminds me of our big picture question. Does God keep his promises?
Oh, well, God always keeps his promises, even when we don't. I really hope King X does too.
Yes, we will be right here with you next week when you and Drowser duke it out.
Kids, don't forget to tune in. You're gonna see Sophia beat Drowser and rescue her brother.
But now it's time for a family connect question. Grab your mom, dad, pop, and anyone else, and we'll see you next week.